हेलो एवरीवन, सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द टॉपिक रिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ लाइट थ्रू अ प्रिज्म। सो इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर्स वी हैड डिस्कस्ड अबाउट रिफ्रैक्शन ऑफ लाइट थ्रू अ ग्लास ब्लॉक। इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस हाउ द रिफ्रैक्शन टेक्स प्लेस थ्रू अ प्रिज्म। सो द क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट इज अ प्रिज्म। आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू नो अबाउट प्रिज्म। ऑल्सो आई होप यू ऑल हैव सीन द प्रिज्म इन द प्रीवियस क्लासेस। सो अगेन we'll study about all the faces of the prism, on what faces the refraction takes place, all that we'll study. So what is a prism? It is a transparent medium bounded by five plane surfaces with a triangular cross section. So this is a prism. As you can see, in this two surfaces are triangular and three surfaces are rectangular. These two rectangular surfaces are the surfaces on which the refraction takes place, so they are known as the refracting surfaces. Now this is the base of the prism. Also these two refracting surfaces, which are the shaded region, you can see that, so they are inclined to each other and they make an angle. This angle is known as angle of prism, and the line joining the two refracting surfaces is known as the refracting edge. So these are the terms that you need to know. What are refracting surfaces, what is refracting edge, what is the angle of the prism, this is the base of the prism. So these are the important thing that you need to know when we will discuss about the refraction taking place through a prism. So that means whenever the ray diagram is given, only this part is drawn, ABC. This is known as the principal section of the prism. So only on this part we represent how the refraction takes place. So ABC and DEF is your triangular surface, ADBE, this ADBE, and your ADFC, ADEB, dude. So ADEB and ADFC and your BEFC, these are your rectangular surfaces. Now BAC, this BAC is your angle of the prism, and AD is your refracting edge. So this AD is known as the refracting edge. Now we will discuss how the refraction takes place through a prism. So that means how, when a ray of light strike on the surface of the prism, how the refraction, and it went inside the prism, then coming out of it, how the refraction takes place, all the process that we are going to discuss. So I already had drawn the ray, this ray diagram, how the refraction takes place. So in this case, this is the principal section of the prism, ABC drawn. Now when a ray of light, this is the incident ray, it will strike on the first face of the prism AB, and on this face when it will strike, so ray of light is going from which medium? See, this prism is made up of glass and outside the medium is air. So that means it is going from air to glass. That means air is your rarer medium and glass is your denser medium. So ray of light is going from air to glass, rarer to denser medium. So it will bend towards the normal. So if we draw normal on this surface, this ray OP will bend towards the normal. So PQ will be your refracted ray. Now on striking on this surface of the prism, this refracted ray on striking on this surface suffers a refraction. That means again it will go from glass to air. That means going from denser to a rarer medium. So it will bend away from normal. So if you draw normal on this surface, this ray of light suffers refraction and it will bend away from normal. So direction will be along this direction. So this will be your emergent ray, this will be your refracted ray, and this will be your incident ray. Now when, suppose there is a no prism here, so in that case the incident ray will go along the straight line path. It follows the straight line path, but due to the presence of the prism, it suffers a deviation. It bends away from the path, it deviates away from the path, and this angle is your delta 1. Now when it strike on this surface, again if there is no prism, so we can, if we extend this emergent ray, so if there is no prism, so it looks out that this emergent ray is appearing from this line MQR, is it so? So that means in that case it deviated due to the presence of the glass prism. So this angle is your deviation delta 2. Now this angle is angle of refraction, and this angle will become for this surface the angle of incidence, so R2 and R1. Now also as I told you, this will be your angle of prism. Now if you extend this incident ray and emergent ray in backward direction, so in that case there will be angle between the extended incident ray and emergent ray, and that angle is known as angle of deviation. So in this case of the refraction taking place from a prism, there is a deviation takes place, and that deviation, that angle is known as angle of deviation. In the previous lecture we had seen the refraction taking place through a glass block, so in that case there was a lateral displacement, but here we have the deviation taking place. So this is the difference between when the refraction takes place through a glass block and refraction taking place through a prism. One more point is that this ray of light must be monochromatic, means a light of single color. We have two types, monochromatic, achromatic light. Achromatic light means light having different color, but monochromatic means a light of single color. Because suppose this light will be your achromatic light, a light like white light which consists of seven color. So when it strike on this surface, after it suffers, there will be refraction, and after that it will comes out, there will be seven color obtained on the screen. So that we'll discuss in the further chapters. So in that case, here we are getting, since it is a single ray of light, so you will see the single ray of light coming out of the prism. So it is important, for this case we are discussing about, this is a ray of light which is monochromatic, a ray of light of single color. Now I hope this whole thing is clear to you, no doubt. So here this I is your angle of incidence, this E is your angle of emergence. Now in some book it is given as I1 and I2. So you can do it by I1, I2. We can write as E, because E I think is more convenient, because you can understand that it is angle of emergence and it is on angle of incidence. Now we have a relation between I, E, A and delta, that is deviation, and that relation is I plus E is equal to A plus delta. This is a very important relation, because in the examination directly the question is asked, write the relation between angle of incidence, angle of emergence, angle of prism and deviation for a prism. So in that case you have directly, you can write this relation, I plus E is equal to A plus delta. That means the sum of angle of incidence, angle of emergence will be equal to the sum of angle of deviation and angle of prism. And sometime the derivation of this equation is also asked. So now we are going to derive this relation, that how we can prove I plus E is equal to A plus delta. So for proving this relation, what we will start with, we have to prove I plus E is equal to A plus delta. So first we'll see that I will be equal to what and E will be equal to what. So you can see that I is equal to delta 1 plus R1 and E will become equal to delta 2 plus R2. How? Mathematics. Vertically opposite angles. So I will become equal to delta 1 plus R1 and E will be equal to delta 2 plus R2. So that's what I am going to write, that I will become equal to delta 1 plus R1, equation 1, and E will become equal to delta 1 plus R2, equation 2. Now adding equation 1 and 2, what we will get, I plus E will be equal to delta 1 and this will be delta 2. Delta 1 plus delta 2 plus R1 plus R2. Now delta 1 plus delta 2, you can see that delta will be equal to delta 1 plus delta 2. Why? Exterior angle is equal to sum of interior angles. So that means we can replace this delta 1 plus delta 2 by delta. So we can write, but delta 1 plus delta 2 is equal to delta, and in bracket you can write that exterior angle is equal to sum of interior angles. So this will become I plus E is equal to delta plus R1 plus R2. Now this is equation 3. What we have to prove, that I plus E is equal to A plus delta. What we are getting, I plus E is equal to delta plus R1 plus R2. That means what we have to get, that means we need to prove that this R1 plus R2 comes out equal to A, and therefore our equation is proved. Now, to prove this R1 plus R2 equal to A, what we'll consider? We'll consider this triangle PQN. So, we know that sum of angle of a triangle is equal to 180 degrees. So, R1 plus R2 plus this angle will become equal to 180 degrees. So, that's what I'm going to write in triangle PQN. What we have? R1 plus R2 plus angle PNQ will be equal to 180 degree. Clear? So we can write angle PNQ will be equal to 180 minus R1 plus R2. Clear? So this give this equation 4. Now we'll consider quadrilateral. Which quadrilateral? AQNP. So in this quadrilateral, now you can see that APN and AQN will be equal, sum of these two angles will be equal to 180 degree. Sum of angle of a quadrilateral is equal to 360 degree. Now you can see that since this normal is drawn, this is 9, this angle will become 90 degree. This is normal to the surface, so this angle will be your 90. Similarly, this angle will also be your 90. So 90 plus 90, 180. So if these two are 180, that means obviously these two must be equal to 180 degree. So we'll write in quadrilateral AQNP, directly I am writing angle A plus angle PNQ will be equal to 180 degree. Angle A plus angle PNQ will be equal to 180 degree. We can write angle A, we can write A only. So because we have to prove A is obviously is angle of incidence, so we will write this, not required to put angle here. So now in this case, angle PNQ, this will become equal to 180 degree minus A, angle of prism, equation 5. Now you can compare this equation 4 and 5, because this is also PNQ and this is also PNQ, so this will be equal to each other. So we'll write comparing equation 4 and equation 5. We get, what we will get? 180 minus R1 plus R2 will be equal to 180 minus A. So that means you can see that A will become equal to R1 plus R2. So therefore A will become equal to R1 plus R2. Now put this relation in equation, this one here, equation 3. So what we'll get? I plus E is equal to A plus delta. What we have to prove? This is what we have to prove. I plus E is equal to A plus delta. See, if you will go step by step, then it will become quite easy for you if you follow the step one by one that I told you. So how you will start? Just keep in mind that you have to start, what you have to prove, I plus E is equal to A plus delta. So find the value of I in terms of delta 1 plus R1. So I will become equal to delta 1 plus R1. Then find the value of E, that will become equal to delta 2 plus R2. You can write from figure I is equal to delta 1 plus R1, E is equal to delta 2 plus R2. Add these two equations, directly you will get I plus E is equal to delta 1 plus delta 2 plus R1 plus R2. So this will become quite easier for you, because you can see that now delta 1 plus delta 2 is replaced by delta. Now your equation become more and more clearer to you. So I plus E is equal to delta plus R1 plus R2. So that means this much you have proved already. What you have to do? You have to replace this R1 plus R2 equal to A. So for that, what we'll consider? We'll consider this triangle PQN and we consider this quadrilateral AQNP. And then we'll write that R1 plus R2 and this angle will be equal to 180 degree, and this angle will also be equal to 180 degree. When you will compare, you will get A is equal to R1 plus R2, so I plus E will become equal to A plus delta. So I hope that this derivation is clear to you. This is very important topic. This diagram is very important, how to draw the diagram. See, to draw the ray diagram, now since this is a chapter about light, so in light, the question that will be asked is majorly about drawing the ray diagram. If your diagram is correct, then half point you will get, means the 50% thing is correct. And if suppose the direct question is asked only to draw the ray diagram, then only if you know the diagram you will get the full marks. So for that, what you will start, you draw a triangle first. First draw the triangle, then draw the angle of incidence, then draw a normal. Clear? Similarly, take this line. Now when it will incident on this surface, complete this ray of light. Show the refraction taking place inside, emergence. Now draw a normal. They will cut. Now start, extend this ray of light and extend this ray of light. They will meet at this point, so this will become delta. Now give the name. This will be I, this will be E, this will be R2, this will be R1, delta 1, delta 2 and delta. Clear? This will be your diagram. Now start proving. As the step I told you, this, if this step you will follow, then very easily you can prove the relation I plus E is equal to A plus delta. This is a very important relation. So learn this relation, learn this ray diagram. If you have any doubt, then you can send me your query. Thank you so much.